I don't know about you, but I went to the Escapist Expo this year and just about lost my mind during the live performance by Gavin Dunn, aka Miracle of Sound. He sang this.
Yo ho, yo ho, we're all beneath the black flag. Hurrah, can we go? We own the sea and sky.
I have never felt more like I was surrounded by singing, surly, rum-drinking pirates. So this got me thinking. With the release of Assassin's Creed Black Flag this week, let's get our scurvy on with the top 5 pirate games. Arr! Number 5, Zack and Wiki Quest for Barbaros Treasure. I'm a big fan of puzzle games because, let's face it, we spend so much time just blowing shit up and sniping people's foreheads off and chainsawing our way through bug aliens that sometimes we just need to use our freaking brains. I had a hard time finding games that didn't make me feel like a flailing moron when the Wii came out, so Zack and Wiki was a pleasant surprise. It's a very difficult puzzle slash point and click adventure game disguised as a harmless kiddie platformer. It's got a charming style and a fun pirate theme, and those puzzles, they're insanely ingenious. Ah yes, a lovable hero searching the world for riches with an annoying orange sidekick. It's our story, Kevin! Number 4, Tropico 2 Pirate Cove. You may remember Sean playing Tropico 4 that time I hit him with a banana. In other words, we're big Tropico fans over here. If you actually want to live the day-to-day life of a pirate, like control the business operations of an island and try not to piss your fellow pirates off, Tropico 2 is the perfect management sim for you. In this Tropico installment, you're not a dictator, you're a pirate king. It's less swashbuckler and more almighty knower of all things. Plus, if you run out of money in this one, you can just, you know, steal more. Number 3, Legend of Zelda Wind Waker. Talk about extreme reactions to a game. When Wind Waker came out, Zelda fans everywhere pooped their jammies. Some with joy, some with overwhelming nerd rage, which is the smelliest kind. Cell shading invokes rage, who knew? And a Zelda game with pirates? What a cool twist on the series. I personally think the game is beautiful, and when sailing, the world feels vast and bright. The islands feel like a really fun place to visit. Sort of Neverlandish. This series facelift gave fans a fun and much needed shakeup. I, for one, welcome Princess Zelda as a pirate leader. I mean, damn, look at that tan. Number 2, it's Goof Troop for the Super Nintendo. As a Capcom SNES game, it is awesome as expected, but the pirate theme seems entirely unexpected. While Goofy and Max are out fishing, they see a giant pirate ship with Pete and PJ kidnapped. Oh sh**. Complete with fighting enemies and solving puzzles similar to the original Zelda, you can play as either Goofy or Max. Goofy deals more damage, but Max is faster. Use a grappling hook to hit enemies or a bell to distract them, causing
a diversion.
And hold up to 2 items, or 1 each if you're playing multiplayer. Yes, this game has multiplayer. In fact, this game was made for co-op. It's way more fun to play with a friend. Awesome music, beautiful graphics, a pirate theme, and friggin' teamwork! But unfortunately, no Leaning Tower of Cheesa.
It's the Leaning Tower of Cheesa!
And the number 1 pirate video game? Booty for the Commodore 64. Duh, of course not. Obviously, it's The Secret of Monkey Island and every other Monkey Island game in the Monkey Island series. Monkey Island, Monkey Island, Monkey Island! You guys already know these are the games that turned me into a gamer. They began as point-and-click adventures following the lovable Guybrush Threepwood as he desperately tries to complete quests and become a pirate. That way, he can sail to Monkey Island and save the beautiful Governor Elaine Marley from the evil ghost pirate LeChuck. Gotta save them sexy redheads. Then I nearly had a nerdgasm when the HD remakes were announced for the first 2 games, but I'm not exclusive here. The Curse of Monkey Island, in more of a cartoony style, was also a blast. Even Escape from Monkey Island and the Telltale episodics were great. I can't get enough of the pirate world that Ron Gilbert has created, and one day I'll get my Monkey Island movie, damn it. But until then, I'll keep trying to get LeChuck to tell me what the secret of Monkey Island actually is.
You don't even know the secret of Monkey Island, do you?
No, not really.
That's it for pirate video games, but if you want an awesome one for the iPad, go download Scurvy Scallywags by Ron Gilbert. I'm telling you, it is awesome. Just trust me. Tweet all your love, hate, and respectful disagreements to @LisaFoyles, and I will see you next week for another Top 5.